Hi everybody, I am Professor Muralidhara Vaidya. I welcome you all to my YouTube channel
Murali's World of Physics.
I am a physicist and I retired as professor and head of the Department of Physics, University of Calicut in 2010. In this series of videos, I would like to present some of the fundamental concepts, ideas and principles of physics. I hope all of you will enjoy these videos. I do wish that it will be of use and of interest to children as well as to grown-ups alike. I will try to couple these ideas, concepts, principles, etc. with some simple experiences that we come across in our day-to-day life. If you like these videos, kindly click on the like button and share with your friends so that they are also enabled to watch these videos. Please also subscribe to my channel and don't forget to click on the bell icon so that in future you will get notifications on my upcoming videos. Physics, according to me, is one of the two most fundamental sciences, the other one being mathematics. Of course, physics takes as input the various principles, theorems, laws, equations, derivations, etc. from mathematics. The other sciences take as input from physics in the form of the various principles, concepts, ideas, theorems, laws, equations, processes, etc. For example, astronomy, astrophysics, geophysics, geology, computer science, electronics, chemistry, even the biological and life sciences. In fact, engineering and technological fields are nothing but applied physics. In fact, the connection between physics and mathematics is a very intimate one. Every physical process possible can be described by a corresponding mathematical equation. Not only that, starting from that mathematical equation, we can apply some mathematical manipulations, valid manipulations, and arrive at some other equation, which then will represent a related facet of that particular process.
For example, consider a stone falling freely under gravity. So we will just release the ball from a particular height above the ground level. Stone will fall down and its height above the ground will decrease. Height h of the stone above the ground at time t is given by some function of time t, f of t. This function is given by h of t is equal to capital H minus half gt square, where g is called the acceleration due to gravity. Its value is equal to 9.8 meters per second squared. Now we will apply the mathematical operation of differentiation, that is d by dt of h of t is equal to minus gt. Now this equation is a very valid result satisfied by the physical process under consideration. It is called the velocity of the particle and is equal to v of t is equal to minus gt.
This example illustrates the deep and intimate connection between physics and mathematics. That section of physics which employs mathematical methods and tools to explain physical observations, in order to understand natural phenomena is called theoretical physics. On the other hand, experimental physics tries to do or make actual observations on physical objects and the processes that involve these objects via necessary equipment and measuring instruments. Involves collecting experimental data using these equipment and measuring instruments and then trying to analyze these data with the help of, again, the mathematical methods and tools in order to draw valid results and conclusions therefrom. In certain cases, even new phenomena or processes are even predicted by such experiments. The two aspects of physics, namely the theoretical physics and experimental physics, always go hand in hand, one complementing the other. Sometimes theoretical physicists put forward a new theory or model based on the results of an already performed experiment. It is then left for the experimental physicist to devise a new experiment or modify an already existing experiment suitably in order to prove this theory or model, or maybe sometimes to disprove. A very good example to illustrate this point is the prediction that a new fundamental particle, neutrino, should exist in order to explain the unusual features of the beta decay process. It was much later, in 1956, about a quarter of a century later, that such a new fundamental particle called the neutrino was actually experimentally detected by Rankine and Cowan. On the other hand, it may also happen that while carrying out an experiment which was supposed to study a particular phenomenon, and some results are obtained. So in the midst of doing such experiment, an unexpected result was observed. And of course, the experimentalist will try to convince himself by further experimentation that that result is true. So in such a case, this new result or observation will then has to be explained theoretically by maybe applying mathematical methods and tools. So this may happen later. So an example to prove this point is the discovery of the new process of superconductivity by Kamerling Ohms in 1911. For quite a long time, all theoretical attempts to explain this process did not succeed. And it was finally in 1957 that the theoretical physicist trio of Bardeen, Cooper and Schrieffer finally put forward the first microscopic theory of superconductivity, which has since then been known as the BCS theory. Now, I think it is time for me to address a very important and pertinent question. After all, what is physics? Putting in a nutshell, physics is the branch of science that studies the two fundamental entities in the universe, namely matter and energy, and also the forces and interactions between these two. Matter has been formally defined as anything which occupies space and has the fundamental property called mass. So this category includes the tiniest objects, the tiniest submicroscopic particles called quarks on the one hand, and the gigantic stars and galaxies and other heavenly bodies on the other extreme. Energy is formally defined as the capacity to do or perform work. It can exist in various forms, like kinetic energy, which is the energy because of the motion of the object, potential energy, which is basically connected with the energy of the position of the particle in a force field, chemical energy, electrical energy, thermal energy, magnetic energy, nuclear energy, etc. Matter and energy apparently are two distinct entities. They have their own individual identities. However, they are like the two sides of a single coin. They are interrelated and interconvertible. Now that is the essence of Einstein's famous mass energy relation, E is equal to mc squared. In my channel, Murali's World of Physics, in my upcoming videos, I would like to discuss and explain some of the basic facts from physics and then try to correlate them with our day-to-day experiences in our lives. This is a brief introduction about my videos in the YouTube channel. This is Professor Muralidhara Varia signing off. Till we meet again in my next video, goodbye. Goodbye.